Are you a visual learner? I know I am. According to a study done by Atlassian, 65% of people identify themselves as visual learners. In this video, our second in the Milanote series, I'm going to be sharing with you how to visualize and map out a workflow. Let's start the action. Okay, so here we are in Milanote, and we have a brand new, fresh board. We'll just go ahead and close this. The first thing I like to do when mapping out these kinds of workflows is to think about the big rocks or the major milestones that I'm going to be having as I go through the process. So first, I'm going to grab a new board. And the first thing I'm going to start with is a discovery call. Most of the time when I first interact with a client, it's through the discovery call. Now, that's a short 15-minute phone conversation where we kind of decide whether or not it makes sense to have a longer in-person conversation. If the discovery call goes well, then we usually will move into a discovery meeting. That's a longer, like 45-minute in-person meeting, back when we had in-person meetings, or a Zoom call. And we'll sit down and go through all of the details of the project. Once we've had a meeting with all of the relevant stakeholders in that discovery meeting, we'll move on to pre-production. Next, we go into production. And then we go into the review stage. So I'm just going to select all of these and reposition it. Now, when I'm working with clients, I usually give them two rounds of revisions. So I'm going to put a second board to represent that. But instead of dragging and dropping, I'm just going to right click, duplicate board. And there we go, we've got a copy. And now I'm going to add another board to represent the final delivery stage. And again, we'll select all these and reposition them a little bit. And the other thing I can do is I can select all and align. And while we're at it, why don't we connect all of these? So I'm going to select all, right click, and go to connect. And that'll draw in lines for us. I also want to change the color, so I'm going to select all again. Okay, so that looks pretty good. We've got all the major milestones here. We've got the discovery call, discovery meeting, pre-production, production, review one, and oh, let me fix that. Reviews. And the final delivery. Just adjust that. Okay, now the next thing I want to do is I want to add in the tools that I use during each of these stages. So I'm going to put in a board here, and this is going to be Dubsado. Dubsado is a CRM, or customer relationship management application, that allows me to schedule appointments, get contracts signed, and send out invoices. Okay, next I'm going to change the color of this icon. So for the tools, we're going to make those yellow. And I'm going to connect that to the discovery call. I'll use Dubsado and send to my clients a custom link so they can book an appointment for that call. And the same thing goes for the meeting. So we're going to make a copy of the Dubsado tool and connect it to the discovery meeting. We also have the ability to label these connections. So I'm going to move this out a little bit. And we're going to add a label. Schedule meeting. I'm also going to use Dubsado to schedule that pre-production meeting too. So let me make a duplicate of the board. Just select, right click, duplicate, and put that there. At this point, we've got a pretty good layout of all the major milestones, but now would probably be a good spot to start adding in some of the more detailed steps. For example, after the discovery meeting, I actually do a proposal. So I'm going to add that in. And we're going to change this connection. And after the proposal comes a contract. And because we want to get paid, we want to add in a deposit. And I'm just going to rearrange a few things here. And just to make things look a little bit different, we're going to select these and we're going to change the color. Green sounds good. One of the reasons I started using Dubsado is because it gives me the ability to send and sign contracts. You can also do proposals in Dubsado, but I actually use those as more of a statement of work to get approval. And for the proposals that I send to clients, I actually use Adobe Spark. To collect those deposits for my payment processing, I'm going to use either Square or PayPal. And since these are all tools, I want to select them all, and I'm going to change the color to yellow. Okay, let's jump over to the review section. Now, for the last couple of years, I've been using an app called WavePost to do client reviews, but I just recently heard that frame.io is partnering with Adobe, so I might be switching over to that pretty soon. But for our purposes, I'm just going to drop these in and we'll duplicate that for the second revision. Okay, and then for the final delivery, I'm sure there's a much more elegant option out there, but I've been using Dropbox and Google Drive. And again, we'll select all of these and change the color, make all the tools yellow. Now, maybe in this workflow, we also want to keep track of how people end up finding us for the discovery call. This is one of those times I wish I had the little highlighted cursor. I'll have to be sure to do that for the next time. Anyway, we can add in boards to represent different traffic sources. So maybe it's a referral or social media, or maybe it's just organic traffic. And why don't we change the color for these as well, just so everything looks a little different. Before we go into the last steps, I wanted to take a quick second to say, I know I'm dropping a whole lot of tools on you, so I'm going to leave links to everything that I mentioned in the description. If you like this video, be sure to hit that like button. And you know what? Go ahead and share this with all of your other visually inclined friends. Okay, so now the last step that we want to do is we're going to add some labels to this so that we can distinguish the different phases. So I'm going to grab a text card, and this is the discovery stage. And I'm going to format this text here, and I'm going to make it a large heading. Just resize it. And then I'm going to go through and I'm going to label all these other phases. Oh, and you know what? I just realized I forgot a very important phase or an important step. We got to get paid right here. So prior to final delivery, we want to make sure that we get our final payments. So let's move these over. Whoops. Let's try that again. Grab these and move those over. So I'm going to jump over here and make a duplicate of the Dubsado board, because that's what we're using for our invoicing. And then we're going to add another board to represent that final invoice. Now we want to make sure that we get these all color-coded and connected up. And then we'll just zoom out so we can see the whole board. And there you have it, a full client workflow. I hope you got some value out of this and got some insight on kind of how to think through using Milanote. Be sure to stick around for the next video because we're going to be using the web clipper to create a mood board.